Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for attending this talk. My name is Mariano Martin from the University of Salamanca in Spain, and today we are going to talk about a multi-scale analysis approach for the design of power-to-gas-to-power facilities, and we are going to consider technical and social issues in order to substitute base load. We are well aware of the fact that even though we have enough energy in the form of solar or wind, the variability affects the way we can meet the demand. In order to do so, apart from integrating different renewable resources, it is possible to store this energy in the form of chemicals. Among them, we can consider the production of metal hydrides, that after the release of hydrogen, that hydrogen can be used in fuel cells in order to produce power. We are going to consider a multi-scale analysis in order to first evaluate the process at the yield and consumption, the raw material needs, and so on and so forth, and with that perform a macroscale analysis to substitute the current base load that use nuclear and thermal power plants. The process consists of different stages that we are going to evaluate over the next slides, and starts with the production of hydrogen that it will be later stored in the form of a metal hydride. That hydrogen is going to be released and finally use in a fuel cell. We are going to describe each one of the stages over the next slides. First, the water is cleaned up and prepared. Later, we are going to use solar or wind energy in order to split that water. We can produce oxygen, which is going to be an asset for the process, as well as hydrogen. The oxygen from the electrolyzer is going to be just compressed to be sold to the market, while the hydrogen is going to be, first we have to remove the traces of oxygen as well as dehydrate it before it can be stored over a small period of time to mitigate the variability over time in short periods, and later that hydrogen is going to be used for the production of magnesium hydride. This is the part in which we are going to store the hydrogen in for a longer period of time. Later, at demand, we are going to use that hydride with water, we decompose it, we generate the hydrogen back, and we produce magnesium oxide. The magnesium oxide is to be regenerated by a carbon reduction, so that we have a cycle of magnesium within our facility, or it can be considered a part of a different facility. Finally, the hydrogen is going to be used in a fuel cell, and the water consumption is the water that saturates the nitrogen that comes out of this fuel cell. So here we consider, we present some results on two different operative modes. On the one hand, we consider the regeneration of the magnesium oxide in situ, and the second consideration is the fact that we may send that magnesium oxide for a different facility to regenerate it. The difference in between the two is, on the one hand, the power to power ratio. The regeneration of the magnesium oxide is really energy consuming, and as a result, the energy that we need to provide for the entire system to operate is far higher. We target the production of 16 gigawatts, which basically is the power that is being generated currently in nuclear and thermal power plants. Both are going to be closed down over the next years. The thermal power plants based on coal are already being shut down, while the nuclear are expected to close down over the next 10 years or so. For that system to operate in the entire country, we will be needing between 2 and 8,000 wind turbines, and between 52 and 200 million PV panels. And that's the difference between using in situ regeneration or off-site regeneration. In terms of cost for these facilities, we can see that on the one hand, the regeneration requires almost twice the investment cost, while the production cost is smaller in case we can regenerate it in situ. We can also obtain some credit from the hot streams within the facility, because we can use them for district heating. We also have the possibility of selling the oxygen to obtain some credit. So after the credit, we can reduce the production cost almost by 2/3 in both cases, achieving a production cost of electricity which can be competitive in the market. For the allocation, the larger scale analysis of the facility, we see two different possibilities. To the left of the slide, you can see the no regeneration alternative. In that case, the production of power is reduced compared to the second alternative. Only 13.7 gigawatts are to be generated. And as we can see, solar panels are going to be allocated towards the Mediterranean coast of the country, while wind turbines are allocated in different areas, mostly the ones with the larger wind velocity across the country. You see also on the slide the allocation of the current power plants that are to be substituted. And we consider in this first approach, in these first cases, that the allocation is going to be maintain, just substitute the current facilities by the ones we are designing. In the second alternative, if we have to regenerate the magnesium oxide, we realize that far larger energy we have to provide, 51.5 gigawatts, and as a result, not only more PV panels are to be installed, and we see that not only in the Mediterranean coast, but also in the interior, like Badajoz, Cáceres, and so on and so forth, are going to be selected for the installation of these panels. And also the allocation of up to 8,000 wind turbines across Salamanca, Zamora, Avila, Madrid, and so on. However, it is expected that over the next years, it's not only that the cost of the wind panels, wind turbines and PV panels is going to improve, but also the efficiency of the system. As a result of both, the operating cost and the efficiency of the entire system will improve. So on the slide, we can see how we start with a base case scenario using the current prices for the fuel cells, the PV panels, wind turbines, and electrolyzer, and two different cases that are expected to take those values over the next 10 years, improving the efficiency of the electrolyzer, the fuel cells, as well as reducing the cost of the different units. As a result, before credits, we see that it is already possible to reduce the electricity production cost from 0.3 euros per kilowatt hour to almost 2/3, to 0.11 euros per kilowatt hour. We also perform some sensitivity analysis for the current case to realize how it is possible to evaluate and to affect the production cost and investment as a result of the improvement in these technologies. The second scenario we are considering here is the fact that we consider in this case, together with the regeneration, the second and third scenario presented in the previous slide, where the efficiency and the cost of the different units improve over time. As a result, we no longer need those many turbines and PV panels, but also we of course reduce the cost of the system. So we've just to summarize a little bit on the process stage before going to the social issues, the installation of this new system is going to affect the society, because we are going to install a large number of units all across the country, generating wealth and jobs. So the idea now will be, how and where should we install those facilities so that the impact in the economy and society is best? So we are going to define three different indexes. The first one deals with the unemployment ratio. We are going to encourage the installation of the different facilities in regions where the unemployment ratio is higher, so that we equilibrate the system. The second one is going to consider the GDP. Those regions with a lower GDP are going to get additional help, in the sense that we are going to promote the installation of these facilities there. And finally, because unemployment is not directly related to the current situation, when there is no employment in a region, people flee that region. As a result, unemployment is not a representative of the current problem. So we are going to consider the density of the population, so that we favor the installation of the facilities in regions where they are more underpopulated. So we are going to consider the base case, where these facilities are located where they are currently are, either thermal power plants or nuclear ones. And first, we optimize the economics. We just locate the power plants randomly, because actually there is no constraint on them, and basically the system considers to locate them to the south. If we optimize the selection of jobs, there are two important results. First, there is no installation of wind turbines. And the second one is that we are going to favor the south west part of the country, apart from small facilities to the north. If we favor the GDP, in this case, we already install a number of wind farms across the country, in particular to the west side of the country, and the solar panels are also located to the north, where the solar radiation is not that high, but the regions favor the most because of the installation of these facilities. Finally, the fifth case is the case where we consider underpopulation for the installation of these facilities, and we have to the right the economic selection of places. So in this case, we again do not select the installation of wind turbines, and we select the installation of the power transformation facilities just to the north, basically because are the less populated areas. Basically, what happened is that most of the people moved to Madrid, Barcelona, looking for jobs and better quality of life because of the economy of their native regions. So just to summarize, basically we've evaluated the first five cases presented on the slide, where we consider the allocation of 12 power facilities that are the ones currently in place. However, if we target economics, the system looks for 16. If we target the production of jobs, GDP, and people density, we target 10, but the sizes change as a result. Basically, social solutions are more costly. So one of the things we are going to do is a multi-objective optimization, where based on the economics, we are going to reallocate the different facilities. So this is the selection. If based on the economic evaluation, we just reallocate the facilities for the jobs, for the generation of jobs, you see the location of the facilities towards the south of the country. If we also target GDP, the selection of the allocation of facilities is almost the same. What is changing basically is the size of the ones. And if we target population density, we realize that the facilities are located towards the middle of the country. So with this, I like to just jump to the conclusions. First, we've developed a facility for the production of power out of the storage of solar and wind energy, depending on whether we regenerate the intermediate magnesium oxide. We have to provide more or less energy. the investment cost and the production cost is something that is going to evolve over time, but we can get promising values over time as the technologies improve. And the installation of this entire system can help society by generating jobs, generating GDP, and helping the population density. So, however, the solution is depending on that. Thank you for your attention. I'll be happy to take any questions.